Hello, everyone. Welcome to the video on guest attestation for Azure Confidential VM. My name is Renuka Prasad. I'm a product manager in the Azure Confidential Computing team. In this video, I'll cover an overview and mechanics of guest attestation. Two common customer scenarios: how to use the out-of-the-box attestation client executable, various attestation claims, guest attestation integration with Microsoft Defender for Cloud, recommendations and alerts available in Microsoft Defender for Attestation. Guest attestation feature helps to verify that a confidential VM runs on a hardware-based trusted execution environment with security features, isolation, integrity enabled. The attestation workflow involves three main parts: the hardware, confidential VM, and Microsoft Azure attestation. Inside the confidential VM consists a customer workload that is built with guest attestation library inside. The customer workload makes a call to the guest attestation library. The guest attestation library retrieves the hardware report and sends the hardware report to MAA for verification. A response in the form of JSON web token is received by the customer workload. The customer workload can decode and extract claims present at the JWT. In a basic scenario, if the 7SNP and CVM claims are present, this indicates that the CVM is running on a trusted execution environment with security features on. The workload can proceed to fully loading itself and can be assured that confidentiality promises such as memory encryption, integrity are in place. Let's say you have a sensitive HR workload in Azure, a recent lift and shift workload from your on-premise environment. The goal is to ensure the HR workload runs in a hardware trusted execution environment. You can use a standard program called Trusted Execution Environment Checker provided by Microsoft. The T-Checker program uses the attestation workflow as shown and extracts the claims from JWT. You can use this program to determine if the CVM has the desired claims. If it does, you are assured the confidential environment is in a desired state, and then you can launch the HR workload. In this scenario, a code signing service provides code signing using HSM-based keys. The code signing service consists of two distinct services: a service named code signing service that accepts the code files and hardware security module in a secure environment. The HSM is the relying party that needs assurance that the code signing service is trustworthy before it signs the code using a HSM key. A customer submits code files to be signed to the code signing service. The code signing service uses the attestation workflow to get a JWT. It sends the VTPM signed payload and JWT to the HSM service. The HSM service extracts JWT artifacts. Using the VTPM ephemeral key, it ensures that the payload is not tampered. The HSM service then proceeds to signing the code files using MSPKI key and sends it back to the code signing service, which in turn sends the HSM signed payload back to the customer. In this demo, I'll discuss how to perform attestation and view JWT claims. First, I'd like to show the guest attestation GitHub repository. Here you can find source code and related libraries you would need to incorporate attestation capability in your confidential VM. Out of the box, guest attestation client is available as an executable and in source code form. You can use either of these or directly use a guest attestation client library to perform attestation inside a confidential VM. The executable is handy to use in your deployment scripts. I'll now show how to perform guest attestation using the attestation client and also referred to as T-Checker. I'm remotely connected to the CVM via SSH. First, I'll run the program with no arguments. If attestation is successful and the token has 7SNP and CVM claims, the program returns true. Next, I'll run the program with an argument to return the JWT. I'll copy and decode the view and claims. As you can see, there are several claims in the decoded view of the JSON. You can see host data, attestation type, secure boot, VTPM, and launch measurement of the attestation report. Next, I'll run the program with an additional argument to include a nonce to ensure freshness. I'll copy and decode the token and view the claims. in the decoded token will specifically view the nonce value. The nonce value is encoded. I'll use this tool. Now you can see the nonce value that was specified earlier in the command. In all three variations of the command, the attestation request remotely verifies with Microsoft Azure attestation that it's running on an AMD machine with 7SNP memory encryption, and the entire firmware and software stack matches the expectations of the trusted computing base. This attestation client program and output taken can be used within a deployment script at runtime to verify the environment before an app unlocks and processes data, keeping customers in control at all times. I showed some of the commonly used claims available. This slide shows additional 7SNP claims and some other common claims. For a full list, please visit the link at the bottom of the page. Guest attestation is integrated with Microsoft Defender for Cloud. The integration allows for managing attestation recommendations and alerts with other security-related functions in a single pane of glass in MDC. Guest attestation extension is required to receive recommendations and alerts in MDC. As you see in the diagram, guest attestation extension must be installed on the confidential VM. The guest attestation extension performs the attestation request periodically and reports recommendations and alerts to MDC, where you can take remedial actions. In this demo, I'll show attestation-related recommendations and alerts for confidential VM in Microsoft Defender for Cloud. The demo setup consists of four CVMs on Linux and Windows with a few parameters with different settings to demonstrate recommendations and alerts. Also shown here is a list of recommendations and alerts. I'll now go to the Microsoft Defender for Cloud page in Azure portal. I'll first show recommendations. I'll click on all recommendations and type in secure boot in the search box. I'll click on the secure boot recommendation for details. The first tab shows all unhealthy VMs without secure boot on. One of the VMs in the demo setup is in an unhealthy state. I can click on it and do a quick fix to turn on secure boot right from MDC. If I click on the healthy tab and filter on my demo VMs, I see three others that are in a healthy state. Similarly, when I search for guest attestation in the search box, I see a few recommendations. I'll click on the recommendation for details. One of my CVMs is missing the guest attestation extension, hence it is showing unhealthy. You can remediate this by clicking on the fix button. Next, I'll show guest attestation alerts. Upon filtering, we can see an alert on one of my four CVMs that has been active for a few days. Clicking on the latest instance, you can view additional alert details on the right side. You can also view recommendations and alerts using inventory page. The links on the slide provide additional information on guest attestation for confidential VM. These links are also included in the video description below. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.